Happy solstice, everybody. Welcome to Shay Durrant, Shoreham Beach, West Sussex, 21st of December 2020. What a Christmas it's going to be. Today is the winter solstice, and during this concert, the sun will go down and we shall be in the middle of winter. Jupiter and Saturn will be conjoined, moving into Aquarius. The world will change for the better. I'm going to be joined by my children shortly. I think they're powdering their noses. And they've left me to it to welcome you all. Thank you for tuning in. So Kemp's jig, followed by a Sussex tune, and then the Dance of the Washerwomen, and finally an Italian jumping dance, so you can do some jumping before the sun sets on this shortest day of the year. Happy solstice, everybody. Now, we've got a pile of music ready for you this afternoon, but we also have six films that we are going to show you during the course of the concert. And these are very special films because, of course, this concert would normally be taking place in the beautiful parish church in Wilmington, Sussex, at the feet of the Sussex Downs opposite the Long Man of Wilmington. But of course, no live gigs this year, at least precious few. So instead we're at home in the studio, and we have called upon some of our lovely friends who we make music with under normal circumstances, and have created, I suppose, what are effectively lockdown films. They're very Christmassy. My daughter Daisy has been editing away like crazy on Final Cut. We have asked Nick Pynn, who normally does the Christmas tour with me, Nick Pynn, the wonderful fiddle player and composer, to contribute. Also Amy Kakoura, a regular on the Christmas tour. Amy's got a wonderful voice. And both Nick and Amy have sent us recordings for these films from their home studios, and we glued it together down here in Sussex. So to begin with, something really to set the mood for this solstice. This is the Like Wake Dirge, which segues into The Moon Shines Bright. And this film features Mr. Brian Gulland, the wonderful musician and singer, as well as Nick, Amy, and myself, my daughter Daisy, and my son Django. And you're going to meet them in a moment. But first of all, here is our first film.
This ain't neat, this ain't neat, every neat and all. Fire and fleet and candle eat, and Christ receive thy soul. When thou from hence away art cast, every neat and all, to winning your thou comest at last, and Christ receive thy soul.
Film. What a beautiful voice Amy has. Thank you, Amy. Thank you, Nick. Thank you, Brian. Cheers, Daisy, for editing that together. I've been joined by Daisy. Mrs. Daisy. Say hello, Daisy.
Hello. Happy Christmas.
It's already getting dusky outside, so the winter is closing in on us. And we're going to do something very Christmassy. It's not just a time to think of the natural world, it's time to think of the Christian festival of Christmas and what that means to us all, and what it basically means is hope, a message of hope, and we all need hope. So let's try and find the magic of Christmas. And I've asked Daisy to sing a song which she taught me when she was very little. What year were you in then?
Year two, year three.
You were quite small, weren't you? Daisy came home from St. Nicholas School, Shoreham, one day and said, I've learnt a new song. And she taught it to me, and we've been playing it ever since. Daisy did sing it in many of my Christmas concerts. And you know, Daisy, that Amy, I asked Amy if she'd sing it as well. So basically, Amy and I nicked it off you. But we're going to return to the roots of this song now. Just Daisy and I singing Child in a Manger Born, a reminder of Christmas and what that side of this time of year is all about. Child in a Manger Born.
Lies in a cattle store.
manger born. I want to know you more. Know you are near me, love you more dearly, Jesus, my Lord.
Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful singing. Thank you, Daisy.
You're fantastic. Very welcome.
I'm very lucky to have you in my bubble. For that is really what this gig is. This gig is the Durrant family bubble. So you're going to hear today my lovely bubble. And I'm going to invite more children in now. My two sons, Django. This is Django coming in now without tripping over any mite leaves or anything else. It's quite hard in this room.
Yeah.
And then Felix. Felix is going to play bass. Django's on the drums. We're all going to sing and we're all going to see what happens. Now, Daisy has conjured up a very clear, beautiful picture of Christmas. We're going to continue that now. We're going to play for you. God rest you, merry gentlemen. Which segues into the Sussex Carol. Now, there is a PDF available. If you go onto a Facebook post earlier today or into my website, you can actually find a PDF with the words to these carols on, in fact, all the carols that we're going to be singing. So please do sing along. We want you to join in. God rest you, merry gentlemen. You have to watch out, though, because we chuck in a Bella Fleck tune halfway through this song, and then we go straight into the Sussex Carol, which Vaughan Williams heard, sung by Harriet Verrill of Monksgate near Horsham. So it's got some credentials as a Sussex song, and we're all Sussex people around here, so we hope you enjoy this familiar carol. All set? Everyone happy?
Mm-hmm.
Happy solstice.
Angels bring us out of darkness, we see light, which makes all angels to sing this night. fine news of great worth. News of our Saviour, kings on earth. Why should man on earth be sad, since our Redeemer made us glad? And out of darkness we see light, which makes all angels to sing this night. Glory to God and peace to man, now and forevermore. Amen.
Yeah. Well, that's a bit of a surprise. Put the banjo to one side.
Probably best.
What are you saying? Okay, now we come to our second film. Mustn't pick any out as favourites, so I do rather like this one. This features Django as lead singer here. This epic Durrant production. We have a marching band comprising of Brian Gulland, Brian Gulland, Brian Gulland, and Brian Gulland. That's four Brian Gullands.
Plus two see. More Brian Gullands.
Two more Brian Gullands as well?
Yeah.
Six
in total.
Yes, yeah, there are six Brian Gullands. And the rest of us, built on a live session we played in this room. You'll see us playing live, and then we put the other stuff on top. So Django had to take a trip out to a local fort, and the rest is history. So we're going to show our second lockdown film now. This is Don't Stop the Cavalry, Run VT.
Churchill comes over here to say we're doing splendidly, but it's very cold out here in the snow, marching to and from the enemy. Oh, I say, Starfire, fat enough, can you stop the cavalry? To fight almost every night down throughout these centuries. That is when I say, oh yes, yet again, can you stop the cavalry? Mary Bradley waits at home in the nuclear fallout zone. Wish I could be dancing now in the arms of the girl I love. Another bomb on another town while the Tsar and Jim have tea. If I get home, live to tell the tale, I'll run for all presidencies. If I get elected, I'll stop the cavalry.
To the live part of this Winter Solstice celebration. Happy Solstice if you've just joined us. That was one of our lockdown Christmas films, and that was Stop the Cavalry by Jonah Louie, the version by us Durrants and Mr. Brian Gulland. Nick Pynn was in that as well. And thank you to all who took part. What a great Christmas song. We're missing a Durrant, actually. Rooney Durrant, my daughter, isn't with us for this concert. She's fine, she's well, but we're protecting ourselves, as you all should be, from the pandemic. So it seems to be getting closer to knocking on our doors. So we're just being extra safe, and very sad that Rooney can't be with us. However, we are now moving into the section of this concert during which the sun will set, and it seemed very fitting to play a little piece of Bach for you. This is from the fiddle partita in B minor. It's just a beautiful piece of Bach, which really reaffirms my suspicion that Bach actually was not just the greatest composer that ever lived, but was also fully rewilded. He was in touch with forces of nature which enabled him to allow his music to flow in the most natural possible way. It's almost as if it follows a natural course through time and space, and the notes of these movements from the B minor partita almost play themselves. So let's move towards the setting of the sun now with these lovely moments of Bach. Thank you. Midwinter Bach for you there. Now you're going to see another one of our lockdown films, this time one of my songs. This is called Christmas in Our Town, and it was very much written for my children. It's quite an old song now, but this version was recorded this year with the help of the usual friends, Nick and Amy, Brian, and also several other friends who took part in the summer lockdown films. They join in the choruses at the end. But this song is very much about a sense of place. It's about this time of year, the middle of winter, and always in our family, Christmas for us really begins on the solstice, and we take it right through to Twelfth Night. In fact, this year we've decided to do Christmas right up until Candlemas, the time of Imbolc, the 2nd of February, so you won't be seeing our tree burning for a while yet. I really hope you enjoy this film. This is as we move towards the darkest time of the year, any moment. So while we're waiting for the sun to set, here is Christmas in Our Town.
The winter clings to us, thinning the light. The sun low in the sky, staying close to the sea. The solstice stares at us just as we are. And the earth patiently circles a star.
Yeah.
Who was that Father Christmas? I recognise that man, I'm sure. I've seen him somewhere before. That was Christmas in Our Town, by me, and performed by all sorts of people, really. Us lot, and Brian, and Nick, and Amy. Beautiful voice there. Who else did we have in that film, Daisy? We had some of our lockdown friends as well.
Yeah, people who appeared in the lockdown films, including Wook, Matt, Jack, Mark, and PC.
And PC. And Cartilage.
Cat.
And
well.
Cat. And Mummy.
And Louise.
And Louise. And Louise. Louise, who's actually operating the live stream and is under considerable pressure this afternoon. And also we have a wonderful assistant who's safely in the next room working the vision mixer. This is Kat, Janga's girlfriend Kat. So thanks, Kat, for doing the vision mixing. Kat is also going to join in with our next carol. This is In the Bleak Midwinter. This is Christina Rossetti's In the Bleak Midwinter, and we're going to sing for you the Harold Dark setting from the safety of our family bubble, and we hope you will join in. There is a PDF that you may have downloaded. If so, pour yourself some mead, get your PDF out, or Google the words for In the Bleak Midwinter. It's about 20 minutes now until the epicenter of this winter, and we enter the most magical part of the year. A time of hope, a time of introspection, and a time of beautiful things. And we hope you make it through safely and have a beautiful Christmas. This is In the Bleak Midwinter.
Just
Hope you were joining in out there in streaming land. How long till the solstice? I'm going to check. It's about 10 minutes now, so I'm going to play a piece now with Daisy, Django and Felix, and this is a piece by Vivaldi. This is a beautiful slow movement from one of his concerti, from the Concerto in D for soprano lute. For soprano lute, electric bass, MIDI keyboard, classical guitar and drum kit.
Classical drum kit.
Classical drum kit, yes, of course. It will, of course, almost be dark by the time we finish this piece. We're doing both repeats.
And Rowan wasn't meant to be doing.
And indeed, yeah. Felix, like the rest of us, is missing his sister Rooney, who usually plays bass on this number. Well done for stepping in, Felix. Rooney is fine, but we're just making sure that this bubble is intact and that we're all safe.
We so, only had 10 minutes to practice it.
Yeah. Right on thick.
In fact, he's never picked up a bass before.
Yeah, he's had to learn the bass, learn the piece. Okay, here we go. Coming at bar five then, have a rest. Happy solstice. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, I could hear the procession of the planets. The Earth tilting us towards the solstice and the alignment of Jupiter and Saturn. It's all going on, ladies and gentlemen. We're moving into Aquarius now. Ah, I think that's what's going on. A new beginning, perhaps. Who knows? The human race might find a bit of self-respect again now that we got rid of the unmentionable orange man. Perhaps it'd be closely followed by the other unmentionable orange man. The government whose combined intelligence is outstripped by the voles that live under my shed, building sledges, doing something useful. It's a magical time of year. Thank you, guys. Well done, Felix. That wasn't so bad, was it? You played great. Yeah. Nice with drums as well. Good idea. Good idea. Keyboard wasn't bad. Another lockdown film. You can clearly see who is in this film, ladies and gentlemen. This is a carol which is in the Oxford Book of Carols, and the lyrics are on the PDF, which you can root around and find if you're connected to any of my social media sites. But let's just listen to the thing. We're so close to the solstice now. We're going to listen to Torches and see the lockdown film made by Daisy and Co. So, roll VT, here comes Torches. Again, Torches, what a fantastic carol, eh? We are probably 5 minutes away from the sunset now, depending on where you live, of course. And I know there are people from around the world watching this stream. So thank you so much. We really must thank those of you that have bought voluntary tickets, which you can find on richarddurrant.com. It's always slightly awkward talking about such things, but like most other artists and arts venues, we have been hard hit by the pandemic. I think earnings cut to about 10% of what they normally would be. So it's been a tough old year in many ways, but we are blessed to be with each other playing music, and this is a fun bubble to be in. But yeah, thanks if you bought tickets. If you haven't bought tickets, you don't have to, but it would be great if you could. There is a donate page, there's a ticket page on richarddurrant.com. So we're gonna continue. We're ever so close to the middle of the winter. So we're going to play our arrangement of a familiar carol. Which I think will, I hope will inspire you to think of the year to come. Particularly the summer to come. Or at least the spring to come. And the spring is already moving and spreading under your feet. When you walk across your garden or walk through the woods, there's stuff going on under the ground, preparing for the spring. Mm-hmm. film. I'm checking the time, ladies and gentlemen. I'm excited. On Shoreham Beach, the sun goes down in 1 minute. So when we emerge out into the garden after this live stream, it's going to be pitch black. We're going to light a bonfire tonight. Hope you do something to mark the epicentre of the winter. Last year, Daisy and I wrote a song. This song is called The Hoarfrost Song, and it features the usual suspects in this rather wonderful film, which you're about to see. Happy Christmas. Don't go away. Enjoy the film. This is The Hoarfrost Song. Roll VT.
The nights are long and the days cold. The sun dips early as the year grows old. Wood smoke drifting lazy to the stars as the hoarfrost crackles on the trees in the yard.
Blow, blow, the winter wind. Freeze, freeze, the bitter sky. Sing on to the green holly and delve in deep to the wintertime.
The world was green and the nights warm. The skylark sang and the sea was calm. Campfire smoke rose lazy to the stars. But time has passed, now the ground is hard.
Blow, blow, the winter wind. Freeze, freeze, the bitter sky. Sing unto the green holly and delve in deep to the winter time. Blow, blow, the winter wind. Freeze, freeze, the bitter sky. Sing unto the green holly and delve in deep to the winter time.
Long and his nose cold. His knees knock louder as his bones grow old. His memory's drifting lazy to the stars as the hoarfrost crackles on the trees in the yard.
Frost song. Hope you enjoyed that. That weird thing that Brian Gulland was playing, our dear friend Brian, the thing that looked like a walking stick, that was a crumb horn. A beautiful, raspy instrument.
He does use it as a walking stick, though, doesn't he?
Only when he's walking on his knees.
Yeah.
Because they're quite short. The crumb horn, the hoarfrost song. We were going to sing live for you, O Little Town of Bethlehem, as a family, myself and my four children. But Rooney isn't with us today. She's okay. We're just making sure that everyone in this bubble is safe. And as I hope you lot are doing, you have to think on your feet. So we're without Rooney for this afternoon. But we did realise that we had a film of us rehearsing. So instead of the live thing, we're going to do the almost live thing. So please get your song sheets out. O Little Town of Bethlehem, we're going to sing three verses. The first verse, the quiet verse, so silently, and the final verse. Join us in this song. This is our rehearsal from a couple of days ago. O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Silently, how silently.
Back on air. That was our rehearsal of Our Little Town of Bethlehem. I could almost hear you singing. There's a lot of people watching. What wonderful news. Happy Solstice. We're going to continue with another lockdown film. This is the Wexford Carol. And the people performing this carol are the four people that went on the Christmas tour last year. It was my favourite Christmas tour so far. It was a wonderful time. Django came on tour with us for the first time. We made him carry all the gear, put all the lights up, plug everything in, and that was good for starters, but he also played a very fine bit of percussion and the occasional backing vocal. Nick and Amy, of course, were also in the gig van, and we had great fun going up and down the country. We made this song our own, I think, during that tour, so we had to film it for you to include in this concert. So here we have Amy Kakoura singing the Wexford Carol.
Good people, all this Christmas time, consider well and bear in mind what our good God for us has done in sending his beloved Son. With Mary, holy, we should pray to God with love this Christmas day in Bethlehem. At happy morn, there was a blessed Messiah born. The night before that happy tide, the noble Virgin and her guide, a long time seeking up and down to find a lodging in the town. But Margaret, well, what came to pass, from every door repelled, alas, as was foretold, their refuge all was but a humble ox's stall. Near Bethlehem did shepherds keep their flocks of lambs and feeding sheep, to whom God's angels did appear. the shepherds ran that babe to find, and as God's angel had foretold, they did our Savior Christ behold. Within a manger he was laid, and by his side the Virgin Mary.
We're back. That was the Wexford Carol, the beautiful voice of Amy Kakoura.
And the beautiful face of Nick Pynn.
And the beautiful face of Nick Pynn. And myself, and my son here, Django, my eldest son, Django George. Ah, blimey. Well, we're getting towards the end of this concert now. We've got another number left, but Daisy has reminded me to tell you that for the 12 days of Christmas this year, we're going to put up a film every day on Facebook and YouTube. There'll be a combination of the films that you've seen in this concert and the six favourite films from Daisy's lockdown series. These include Reason to be Cheerful, Reasons to be Cheerful and Tubular Bells, amongst others. So it's going to be a very musical Christmas. Before we play our last song, let us all wish you a very, very peaceful, happy, safe Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy solstice. Enjoy the middle of winter and think of good things to come. We're going to end with a Paul McCartney song. He's just released a cracking album. It is an absolutely brilliant album.
McCartney 3.
You've got to enjoy that over Christmas. It's a blinder. The man is wonderful, but then he is a Beatle. And this was one of his songs from 1983. This is Pipes of Peace. So here we go.
Thank you.
Hold that pose, hold that pose. It's still online.